Yeah. So today I'm going to present a presentation on exploiting CVE 2019-20477.
So, you are audible, Dhananjay. Just continue. The stream will be have some delay. So, yeah.
Okay. So first, let us understand what is CVE 2019-20477. This was a vulnerability in PyYAML where an arbitrary code execution can be performed through full load method or the full loader loader. So technically, this vulnerability was while deserialization of an object. So by using this particular method, this is not going to exploit while serialization. This is only going to exploit during deserialization of object. So here you can see this is a simple syntax for deserialization of data. So in load, we have to pass a data, which is data which we want to translate. Later, I will explain what is YAML and why we use PyYAML. Then it will get clear what is this exact data I am talking about. And this is loader equals full loader. So now, just for your information, YAML is a human readable data serialization language. It is commonly used for configuration files and in application where data is being stored or transmitted. So here stored or transmitted, I mean to say about on your local storage or any kind of storage or transmitted via network. Of course, via network, we are talking about computer and vulnerabilities. Yeah, now what is serialization? Serialization is the process of translating a data structure or object state into format that can be stored or transmitted. So here I am talking about translating the data structure or object state into a format which is compatible to stored or transmit. So technically we are here converting the state of an object into a byte stream, and same vice versa for deserialization. So in this serialization, we are converting byte stream into the state of object. So now returning back to about CVE 2019-20477. So first, let me show you how basically we people in a security industry used to demonstrate about any particular vulnerability and all. So I will take one link from reference. So here you can see it's a page from NVD National Vulnerability Database. So you can say this is like a repository for the all newly discovered vulnerability with a CVE ID. So here you can see current description along with base score, CVSS score, and CWE. So here you can see CVSS score is 9.8 as per version 3, where attack vector is network, attack complexity is low, privilege required is none, user interaction is none, scope is unchanged, confidentiality is high, integrity is high, and availability is also high. And CWE is 502. So here CVE is a common vulnerabilities and exposures. This is an unique ID we generally assign to any newly found vulnerability. So basically CVE is followed by the year in which vulnerability was found, followed by a unique ID. Now CWE. This is just a common weakness enumeration.
Sorry to interrupt you. Can you please share your screen once again? Because I guess your screen is getting stopped.
Okay.
No, I can see it on the live stream as well.
Shall I continue?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So CWE, I was at CWE. Okay. So it's a common weakness enumeration. This is a list of common software and hardware security weakness with a particular number. Like for example, CWE 502 means for deserialization of untrusted data. In same way, CWE 400 is for resource exhaustion. Now CVSS score. This is a common vulnerability scoring system which represents characteristics of vulnerability as well as it calculates severity score of vulnerability on a scale of 10. So for this case, here you can see CVSS score is 9.8. So I will only explain the metrics of this particular vulnerability. For more, you can visit CVSS score on my reference this page. There you can find different metrics for attack vector, attack complexity, privilege required, interaction, user interaction, and all. So here, attack vector. Attack vector is network. This means, in short, the vulnerable component is in bound to network stack. In simple word, you can say this can be exploited remotely. Now, attack complexity. Here it is low. This means an attacker can expect a repeated attacker can exploit this repeatedly. The attacker can explain this can exploit this vulnerability. Just hold a second. Okay, now privilege required. This is none. This means that the attacker is unauthorized prior to attack, whether a component or a network. Now here, user interaction is none. This means the vulnerable system can be exploited without interaction from any user. So for this, a user need to interact with that component or any kind of malicious code or crafted code sent to the victim. And there, if for example attacker interact with any way like access that particular crafted file and all, in that case user interaction is required. Now here, a scope change. An exploited vulnerability can only be affect resources managed by the same security authority. In simple sense, component A can affect component B. This means here the scope is changed, and where it's not affecting other component, where a scope is unchanged. Now confidentiality. So here you can see confidentiality is high. This means here is a total loss of resources which are impacting a component. Means all information is getting exposed, all files and all. Now integrity. Here integrity is also high. This means total loss of integrity or a complete loss of protection. Attacker is able to modify any or all files protected by the impacted component. Availability. Here its availability is also high, which means attacker can able to fully deny access to resource in the impacted component. So I will give one example. Mostly we used to see for availability, when availability is high, CWE is 400, which is resource exhaustion. So in this case, mostly system used to attack by denial of service. So basically this confidentiality and integrity and availability plays a big role in CVSS score. So here you can see it's high in all three cases. So here our CVSS score is 9.8. So now we will move to exploit. Okay, before moving to exploit, I would like to show you one thing. Here you can see pi ml 5.1 through 5.12 has an insufficient restriction on the load and load underscore all functions because of the class deserialization. So it simply states that this vulnerability was the attacker was able to exploit only while deserialization issue. So example, popn is a class in subprocess model. And another notable point is here, this was due to incomplete fix of CVE 2017-18342. So you can go on the same NVD page for more about this CVE 2017-18342. So here I will screen two different environment. One environment will be for a version of pi ml below 5.1 and another will be of above 5.1. So as per our vulnerability description, pi ml below 5.1 and 1 is vulnerable and above 5.1 is not vulnerable.
Dhananjay, are you showing the terminal?
Yeah.
So it's not visible, I guess. Only Chrome is visible right now.
Yeah, now I think you are able to see my terminal.
No, it still shows just Chrome. Maybe you can share the whole screen.
Okay.
It's visible now. Yeah, cool. Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. So here on this screen, you can see here I set the environment for PyML 4.2. And on my another screen, here I have created environment for PyML 5.2.5.2. So here you can see a small code how to deserialize any data by using load function. So here I imported YAML package. Then this is a data which is already in a serialized form. Then I passed this A data or object through YAML.load and A. Now I'm trying to print the deserialized data. So if I will run this code on PyML 4.2. Simply it will run and it will not give any warning or error.
Dhananjaya, can you increase the font a little bit? So as it's dark and it's a little bit hard to see in the stream itself. Yeah, this is good. Yeah, just show the code once so that everyone is along with us.
Here you can see I imported YAML package, then this is already a serialized, is a reference to this serialized data. And here again, I'm trying to deserialize by using YAML.load, where I am passing the data within load. And then I am trying to print this deserialized data. Okay. So again, I'll try to run this code. And here you can see it got a simple output without any warning or any kind of error. But when I will try to run this same in another environment with PyML 5.2, so here you can see YAML load warning. So calling YAML.load without loader is deprecated as default loader is unsafe. So even I shared one link from the upstream in my slide in references. Here you can also know how and why this got deprecated. So here the very first line you can see PyML load function has been unsafe since the first release in May 2016. Okay. So according to our vulnerability description, it says an arbitrary code execution can be performed through full load method. So now I will try to use exploit against both the environment for PyML 4.2 and 5.2. But now I'm not going to show you this exploit code, but yeah, you can find on web. So this is my POC 1 PI. So here I use a simple command which is pwd. That's why it's showing my present working directory. Now again, I will try to run this same POC on PyML 5.2 version. So it will again give the same warning, and this time this will not execute because this was fixed in 5.2. And here are the references, whatever I used in this talk. So this was the whole thing about CWE 2019-20477.
Dhananjay, are you sharing the slides? Because only terminal is visible here.
Okay, basically Vishal, I am done with my presentation. So I completed my exploit section also.
Okay, interesting. So let's wait for a few minutes. If anyone has any questions, please post those in the comment section. So I just wanted to know, so if someone is able to exploit this code by some way, and so basically let's say some vulnerable or basically a payload kind of YAML which has something suspicious can be loaded, right? Dhananjay?
Yes. Yes,
yeah,
sir.
So so Bhavin here. So the thing I was wondering about is, let's say someone has a YAML which has some. So basically, I just wanted to know how it all works. So it's like while deserializing it, the method which does the deserialization. Doesn't take into consideration other stuff, right? So it just loads it as it is, and that's why the vulnerability exists, right?
Exactly.
The YAML can have some suspicious code that can get loaded. Is it like that?
Yeah. Is it like that? I would like to clear one more thing. So basically about this vulnerability, an arbitrary code can be executed when it processes an untrusted YAML files through the full load method or with full loader application that you use the library of process untrusted input may be vulnerable to this flaw. And one more thing, this can be also, you also need to use Python/object/apply constructor to execute arbitrary code, which I have covered in my POC, but that was masked. I don't think it's a safe thing to share right. The POC. So basically, right. We also need to use Python/object/apply constructor to exploit this vulnerability.
Cool, got it. So basically, if anyone is using that version of PyAML, it's better to upgrade that, right?
Yeah.
No matter if
it's already deprecated in 5.2.
Okay. Got it. Yeah. No matter how they are using the PyAML object or whole library, it's just better to upgrade it.
Yeah. Or you can also mitigate this by using a safe_load. So this is one mitigation which can also be used in below 5.1.
Okay, so basically if you are not able to upgrade due to some other constraints, make sure you use safe_load.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was nice. Someone is saying want to see POC 1. I guess that's not a good thing to do in a live stream.
Yeah.
Or not even in person as well.
But if you'll try to find out web or find it on web, you will get about how you can attack.
Right. So it's basically some kind of combinations. If you have them in your code, then this will get successfully executed.
And in simple word, you can say using this method is not safe while deserialization of data.
Correct. Okay. I guess there are no other questions. Cool. So thank you so much, Dhananjay. It was a nice brief overview over what CVE is and how one CVE is basically calculated, how properties are calculated, and all the values are calculated, and how that affects different environments and all. That was a really nice overview. Thank you. It was a great talk.
Thank you. Thanks, everyone.